Hello, my dear students. In this class, I am going to discuss first order reactions. Today, I am going to derive first order integrated rate expression. I think in the previous class, you understood integrated rate expression for zero order reaction. And the derivation of the first order reaction is same as that of zero order reaction. We are going to follow the same step here also. Before going to that, you know the first order reaction, that is the order of reaction in which the rate of reaction is directly proportional to concentration of only one reactant, that's why this is called as first order reaction. Now let us consider the decomposition of nitrogen pentoxide. So it gives four molecules of nitrogen dioxide plus oxygen, and this is a first order reaction. Okay, there are the molecularities too, it's a bimolecular reaction, but the rate of reaction depends on only one, so one reactant molecule, that is the rate of reaction increases one times with respect to this, that's why this is a first order reaction. So now you know A is the initial concentration of a reactant and X is the concentration of a reactant which is reacted, and A minus X is the concentration of a reactant which is remaining. Don't get confused. So this is 100% before going to start the reaction, no reaction is started, that's why. So this is initial concentration, then this is the concentration of reactant which is reacted at time t, and this is the concentration of reactant which is remaining, which is not reacted, it is remaining at the same time t. So you must understood these three things, otherwise it is difficult to understand the derivation. And let us consider a general first order reaction in which A gives a product. This is a first order reaction in which N is equal to 1. N is the order of reaction. And we know the rate of reaction. We know the rate of reaction, expression for rate of reaction is dx by dt. This is the differential expression for rate of reaction. And we also know that rate of a first order reaction is equal to rate constant K into concentration of a reactant A and its power 1. Why we have taken 1 here? 1 because it's a first order reaction. And here A is the concentration. Here A is the concentration of a reactant at any time. The concentration of reactant remaining at any time is A minus X. That's why rate is equal to dx by dt is equal to K into A power 1. So K into A power 1 is equal to K into A power, then is equal to K into A power minus K into A minus X. Because your concentration of A is nothing but, so A minus X. That is the concentration of a reactant which is remaining at time t. Because the rate of reaction is not depends on the concentration of reactant which is reacted. Because the rate of reaction it depends on concentration of reactant which is remaining. Because that is going to react. That's why the rate of reaction depends on A minus X. That's why I took A minus X here. So finally we can write this dx by dt is equal to K into A minus X. You write down. This dx by dt is equal to K into A minus X. Next. So this is the equation. Dx by dt is equal to K into A minus X power 1 because it is a first order. Now let us integrate this equation. Integrate this equation. So this is the equation number A, for example. Okay. Integrate the equation number A. So this is the integral form of A. So we cannot integrate this equation. That's why we have to convert into integral form. So at that moment, this a minus x come to LHS. So and it becomes dx divided by a minus x is equal to k into, k is a constant, we have taken it outside, k into integration, this dt comes to RHS, so into integration of dt. So if you integrate this equation, we know the integration of 1 by x. You remember the basics, integration of 1 by x is logarithm, logarithm of x, integration of 1 by x. But here integration of 1 by a minus x is there, but here log means here the base is 10 and ln, natural logarithm, the base is e. So integration of 1 by x is equal to natural logarithm of a minus x. And if you, after integrating a minus x, then you have to differentiate a minus x. So differentiation of a minus, this is the basic rule. Okay, because here along with the x, a is present. The integration of 1 by a minus x is just log of a minus x. Then after differentiating this a minus x, so differentiation of a is 0 and differentiation of x is minus, x is minus 1. That's why, so minus sign comes here. So overall, integration of dx divided by a minus x is equal to minus ln into a minus x is equal to kt plus c. This is equation number 1. So now, so this equation is still incomplete because we don't know the value of c. We don't know time. We can calculate constant. Initial concentration, we know that already. X we can calculate. But we do not know the value of c. That's why we have to calculate the value of c. The value of c can be calculated. So at t is equal to 0. At t is equal to 0, x is also 0. Okay, this is not there. This is not there. At t is equal to 0, why? Because you just look at here. You just look at here. No. So t is equal to 0 means reaction is not started at that moment. So a is equal to 100%. That is, reaction is not started. So initial concentration becomes 100%. And x is equal to 0 in this case. X is equal to 0. That is, no, x is the amount of reactant which is reacted, but at t no reaction started. That's why reactant amount is 0. That's why x is 0 in this case. And substitute the value of t and x in the equation 1. At that moment, this term becomes 0. Minus ln of a minus 0 is equal to kt plus kt. Here t is also 0. That's why this term becomes 0. Then c is equal to minus ln of a. So now you calculated value of a at t is equal to 0 and x is equal to 0. So we have got, so c is equal to, so minus ln a. Next, substitute the value of 2. So equation 2 or value of c in the equation 1. So in the equation 1 is equal to minus ln a minus x is equal to kt plus c. C is what? Minus ln a. So after substituting, you are going to get this equation number, this equation, that is minus ln a minus x plus kt, and value of c is minus ln a. And you simplify this equation and keep kt at RHS and send this ln a to LHS. So it becomes ln a minus, or minus of minus ln a minus x is equal to kt. Then if you apply log a minus log b formula here, then it becomes kt is equal to ln of a divided by a minus x. Log a divided by log b is equal to log a divide log a minus log b is equal to log a divided by log b. Then, so we have got this equation, kt is equal to ln of a divided by a minus x. Then k is equal to what? Take k is equal to 1 by t into. Then if you convert this ln is equal to, we know that 2.303 log. if you substitute the value of ln, then this equation becomes k is equal to 1 divided by t into 2.303 into logarithm of a divided by a minus x. So this is the equation. So after simplifying, you are going to get k is equal to 2.303 divided by t into logarithm of a divided by a minus x, and this equation is called as integrated rate expression for first order reaction. So now let us derive the SI unit for the rate constant. As I said, the SI unit of rate constant is different and rate is different here. So here a is a concentration and a minus x is also concentration. Both in numerator and denominator, concentration is present. That's why concentration get cancelled, and 1 by t per second. Per second is the SI unit of rate constant. SI unit of per second is the SI unit of rate constant in case of first order reaction. Dear student, the derivation is very simple. So before going to derive, first write first order equation. Then apply the law of mass action. Then convert that equation into integrated form. Integrated it and identify the value of C. Substitute the value of C to the integrated equation. Then simplify. You are going to get this equation. Please remember this equation. This is oftenly used to solve numerical problems.